Hi to all the fellow students, lecturer and staff of BMS. In this video, we are going to talk about the hands-on technique and detail about application of Google Meet. Before going deep to talk about using Google Meet, you must make sure that you have a Google account, but as a student of BMS, the Institute has made one for you. You can get your account from System, Maklumat Pelajar, Persepaduan or JTMK website. Please contact the IT department if you have any issue with accessing your account. Next, to experience all of the features of Google Meet, Google has listed out recommended requirements. Google Workplace offers various subscription options for individuals, small business, large organizations, and school, but Google Meet can simply be divided into three categories based on the participant limit. We have the default limit of 100 participants. This option is free and available for everyone. From now, we are going to demonstrate how to using Google Meet. First, all of the lecturer and student have to know their UMS email account. You can also search Google Meet in the search bar and find the meet.google.com. After finishing keying, you can click on continue and then click join now. And here you will see the link of the classroom. Then you can share the link of the classroom to your student to ask them to join in.
You can also schedule a Google Meet session in Google Calendar. First thing first, you need to create an event in Google Calendar by clicking on the Create button over here. Give the event a title. Next, you will need to enter the email of your guest that you would like to invite to the Meet session. Lastly, you need to click on the Save button. And if you would like to send a notification to your guest, you can click on Send. Otherwise, just click on Don't Send. On Google Meet, you can share your entire screen, a window, or a browser tab to your participants. Find the present now on the bottom right. There are three options as mentioned. But in this video, we will be showing you how to share a PowerPoint window to your participants. To do that, you need to choose the window option, find and choose the PowerPoint window from the list, and click on the share button. The participants will now be seeing this PowerPoint window on their meeting screen. On Google Meet, there is a feature where you can have a caption on the meeting screen whenever someone talks. To enable it, you need to find the turn on captions on the bottom right. Click on that, and whenever someone talks on the Meet session, there will be a caption shown on your meeting screen as shown here. There are many ways to take attendance on your Meet session. One of them is to use an extension that you can find on the Chrome Web Store. In this video, we will be using the Google Meet attendance list, and the link to install this extension will be shared in the video description. First of all, you need to install it by clicking on the Add to Chrome button, then click on the Add extension on the pop-up window, and a notification will appear on the top right once it is successfully installed. After that, you can start your Meet session. Go to the top right and find the Show Everyone icon. And under the People tab, you will see a Save Attendance option. Now you can save the list of participants here by clicking on the Save Attendance options under the People tab. Click on it, name it in the pop-up window. Click on the downloaded Excel file and full list of your participants will be saved in the Excel file as shown here.
Post control. If you created a meeting using a UMS email account, you will see a blue shield icon with a padlock beside meeting details. By clicking on it, you will see some options to keep control of your meeting. There are quick access option, share the screen option, and send chat message. For quick access option, if it is enabled, anyone from the same organization can join without waiting for the host to accept it. For share the screen option, if this is disabled, the present now button for participants will be disabled. For send chat message option, by turning this off, you'll disable the chatting feature for everyone except the host.
Changing background. Before you enter a meet, you can simply click on the bottom right corner over here. From here, you can select either you want to blur yourself, your background, or you want to add a background. But keep in mind that blurring or changing a background require a lot of resources and can slow down your device.
Keyboard shortcuts. Google Meet has some keyboard shortcuts which can be viewed by pressing Ctrl-slash. This will bring up the keyboard shortcut help screen, and you can use these shortcuts by pressing the key combination. For example, you can press Ctrl-D to mute or unmute your mic.
Changing the layout. So firstly, when you have joined a video meeting, at the bottom right, click More. You will see the change layout. Just click it. You can choose an option between auto, tile, spotlight or sidebar. For auto, by default you will see 9 tiles on your screen. For tile, the view can be shown up to 49% at the same time, but by default you will see 16 tiles on your screen. For spotlight, you will only can see the active speaker screen or the screen that have been shared. For sidebar, the main image will show up the active speaker screen or shared screen, but you will also can see the thumbnails of additional participants on the side.
Lecturers can add documents, spreadsheet, or even PowerPoint directly to a meeting so that your student will have all the information they need right from the meeting. To do so, simply go through your Google Calendar, click on any previous created event, click on Edit Event, and you will see a small pinned icon named Add Attachment. Once you click on it, you should be able to upload files from your Google Drive or even from your own local PC. Once you're done, just upload it and press save. You can add a virtual whiteboard into your Google Meetings by clicking on the three-dot menu on your bottom right corner and press whiteboard. There will be an option to create a new one or select from the previous inside your Google Drive. Here I will start a new one. Once it's been created, the whiteboard will be pop up as a window. So bear in mind, it will not automatically screen share to your participant. So to screen share, you need to press Present Now, a window, and the whiteboard itself. Here you go.
For the last part, we will show you how to troubleshoot some common issues of Google Meet. If you cannot join a meeting, make sure that you are using the latest version of supported browsers like Chrome, Firefox, Edge, or Safari. You also must be logged into your Gmail account. Then check if you have entered the correct meeting code or link. If you cannot see the option to change your background, you must use a supported browser with Firefox acceleration enabled. To enable it, go to the browser settings, search for hardware acceleration, enable it, then restart the browser. If you get any lags or slowdowns, check if your device meets the requirements and close any unnecessary applications. If you cannot hear or send any audio, check if your devices are plugged in properly. Then make sure they are unmuted and active. And finally, Google Meet must have the permission to use your audio device. To check for permission, go to the address bar, then click on the padlock icon. Make sure that the camera and audio permissions are allowed. That's all from us. Thank you for watching.